It's chemistry, and you are watching Cam Science.
Let's learn what are alcohols and uses of one of the most common alcohol, ethanol. General characteristics of alcohols, molecular and structural formula of first few members of the homologous series alcohols, how are alcohols formed, that is production of alcohols from other compounds, and then chemical properties of alcohols. In this video, we will cover all these points. Alcohols are the family of organic compounds which have OH as the functional group, and examples of ethanol and propanol. So any compound which is an alcohol will have some carbon chain which can be presented in general as an R, and then the OH group, that is oxygen and hydrogen, will be covalently bonded to the carbon chain, and such organic compounds are called alcohols. Ethanol is one of the most common alcohol, and this has very wide uses. So let's first see the uses of ethanol. The first one is that ethanol is an alcohol which is generally found in alcoholic drinks, and that is consumed in many countries. It is also very good solvent because it can dissolve many other substances which cannot dissolve in water. So ethanol is one of the good organic solvent. Also, it is used to make other chemicals such as esters, which are used in food flavorings and in cosmetics. So ester is a very good chemical which is having a very wide use, and it is formed from alcohols. Also, it is used as fuels, which creates less pollution, because if the fuels are made from fossil fuels, it has a very big problem of the air pollution and other pollutions. But if alcohol, common alcohols like ethanol, are mixed with these fuels, or only ethanol is used as a fuel, it creates a less pollution problem. And that's why in many countries it is mixed with petrol and used as a fuel. So let's see some general characteristics of alcohols. Alcohols are an homologous series where it has an OH group as a functional group. Now if we say OH group as a functional group, it means that it will react, that OH part of the molecule is going to react, and that is responsible for the chemical properties of the compounds of alcohols. And that's why all the alcohols will have similar chemical properties due to the presence of this group OH. So they form a homologous series, and the general formula of this homologous series is CnH2n+1 OH. Now in the next part of this video, when we will understand the molecular and structural formula of some alcohols, we'll understand how did we get this general formula. And the first few members of this homologous series alcohols are volatile and are soluble in water, but as the size of the molecule of alcohols increases, that the members go ahead, the volatility decreases and the solubility in the water also decreases, and that's why only first few members are quite volatile and are soluble in water. So now let's understand the structure and molecular formula of some alcohols, first few members of alcohols, that is starting with the methanol. Now meth means number of carbon atom is 1. Now when we say the general formula is CnH2n+1 and then OH, means number of carbon atom is 1, that is 1 carbon atom with hydrogen 3, because if you substitute the value of N as 1, it becomes 2+1, 3 OH. So CH3OH. If we draw the structure, then we just have to draw one carbon bonded to 3 hydrogen, because it is CH3, and then only one carbon present is directly bonded to oxygen, and the oxygen is covalently bonded further with the hydrogen. So this is the structural formula of the first member of alcohol, methanol. The next member, ethanol. Ethanol, eth is n is equal to 2 and all stands for the alcohol. So if n is equal to 2, then we get the molecular formula as C2, and substituting the value of 2 in 2 and plus 1, we get C2H5 and OH. Now if we draw the structure of ethanol, then 2 carbon in chain with each other, and then the first carbon is left with 3 more covalent bonds, because all the carbon should have a total of 4 covalent bonds each. So if one of the covalent bond is with other carbon, the other 3 covalent bonds should be with the hydrogen. Now this carbon is again bonded with OH, so again add O and H, and now the second carbon is left with 2 more covalent bonds to make a total of 4 covalent bonds, so 2 hydrogen are added. So structural formula can also be written as CH3CH2OH, which makes it C2H5OH. And the next member is propanol. Prop means N is equal to 3 with all as an alcohol, so C becomes 3, hydrogen becomes 7 because it is 2N plus 1OH. So again 3 carbon in series with each other, making the first carbon left with 3 covalent bonds bonded to hydrogen. The second carbon should be bonded to 2 hydrogen to make a total of 4 covalent bonds. The third carbon is bonded to O. H is a functional group, so third carbon is also left with 2 more covalent bonds to make it with hydrogen. So if you make a general structural formula, then for propanol it is CH3 because first carbon is bonded to 3 hydrogen. Next is CH2 because second carbon is bonded to 2 hydrogen. Third carbon also CH2 as it is bonded to 2 hydrogen, and then OH can be written. So this is the structural formula of propanol with CH3CH2CH2OH, making the common molecular formula C3H7OH, and the whole display formula showing all the bonds is also shown here. One more member of alcohol series, butanol, is N is equal to 4 with alcohol OL ending. So butanol, which makes the molecular formula C4H9OH. So 4 carbon in series with each other, and the first carbon with 3 hydrogen, second carbon with 2 hydrogen, third carbon also with 2 hydrogen. The fourth carbon is bonded to oxygen and hydrogen, OH group of the alcohol, so the fourth carbon is also bonded with 2 hydrogen. So here the structural formula in general can be written as CH3CH2CH2CH2OH. So this makes the butanol. And with the same method, you can make the molecular and structural formula of the remaining members of the alcohols also. These are just the first 4 members of the alcohol series. Now, how are alcohols made? In general, we generally learn how are ethanol made. So let's first see few methods of making alcohols. First is by fermentation method. Generally, we make ethanol with the help of fermentation method, where any substance containing glucose can be fermented using yeast and in absence of air. If this is fermented, for example, maize or any other grains or sugar cane which contains glucose in it, any such substances can be fermented with the help of yeast in absence of air to get ethanol as an alcohol. The only thing which should be remembered is that the temperature should be between 30 to 40. If the temperature varies much, the process of fermentation stops, and so the ethanol formation also stops. So only few of the conditions you need to remember about formation of alcohols, especially ethanol, by this method. And if we write a reaction in general for this, then we can write glucose as C6H12O6, which in presence of enzymes like yeast is going to react at a given temperature and produce ethanol. Now ethanol is C2H5OH. It's also going to produce carbon dioxide as a byproduct, and energy will also be produced because this reaction is exothermic. So during the reaction, the temperature might increase a bit, and if we balance the reaction, then we need to add 2 with ethanol and 2 with carbon dioxide to make a total of 6 carbon and hydrogen 12 and oxygen 6. The second method of making alcohol from alkenes by its hydration. Now, if we are hydrating ethene, we are going to produce ethanol. But in the same way, if we hydrate any other alkene like propene, then we can obtain propanol. So this is how we can obtain alcohols from the alkene by its hydration. And this can be done by adding water in the form of steam with phosphoric acid as a catalyst and 300 degrees Celsius in 70 atmospheric pressure. But let me write a reaction of ethene here because we are going to produce ethanol. So here C double bond C for ethene with 4 hydrogen of total, and this is reacted with steam. So I'm writing water in the gaseous form. Now this reaction occurs with phosphoric acid as a catalyst. So H3PO4 with 300 degrees Celsius and 70 atmospheric pressure. So these are the reaction conditions needed for this. And ethene is hydrated to make ethanol. So the double bond will change to single bond, and as we have learned the same reaction in the reactions of alkenes also in our earlier video, that across the double bonds one hydrogen and OH is added, changing the double bond to single bond, and this is how water is added to alkene to form an alcohol. So if we use ethene, we are going to get ethanol. If we use propene, we are going to get propanol, and these are the two main methods of producing alcohols. Now let's start with the chemical properties of alcohols, and one of the most common reaction of all the organic compounds mostly, as alcohols also burn well in the same way as the other hydrocarbons burn, giving out plenty of heat. So if we use ethanol as a fuel and burn it, then it's going to have a less impact on the formation of carbon dioxide, and so the carbon dioxide levels may be maintained well, other than the fossil fuels which are used as in fuels, which has a very bad impact on the formation of carbon dioxide levels in the environment. So let's write a combustion reaction for ethanol, that is C2H5OH, that reacts with oxygen to form carbon dioxide and water, because these are the two common products when anything undergoes combustion. And if we balance it, then we need to add 2 with the carbon dioxide to make a total of 2 carbon, and then to make a total of 6 hydrogen on the reactant side, we need to add 3 with water, which makes a total of 7 oxygen atoms on the product side. So we add 3 with oxygen molecules to make a total of 7 oxygen atoms on both sides. The next important reaction of ethanol is ethanol to ethanoic acid. Now this is oxidation because we are adding oxygen into it. Now the structure of ethanoic acid in detail will be learnt in the next video of carboxylic acids. So the first method of changing ethanol to ethanoic acid or any alcohol to its respective carboxylic acid is first by oxidation of ethanol in air with the help of acetobacter. This changes ethanol to ethanoic acid, and the second method of for this reaction is by acidified potassium manganate 7. Now potassium manganate is KMnO. PCO4. This is called potassium manganate 7, and we generally use it as acidified. So we write as H plus besides the KMnO4. Generally, the acidification of potassium manganate is done with the help of sulfuric acid. So we write this as an acidified potassium manganate, and this acidification is necessary for the proper oxidation of ethanol to ethanoic acid. Now if we write a reaction for this, then it is C2H5OH. This is undergoing an oxidation. Now as we know that the potassium manganate is an oxidizing agent, it is not the direct oxygen molecules which is reacting from the air. So now as oxidation is happening with the oxidizing agent, we write O in the bracket like this because it is oxidized with oxidizing agent, not with air. So we can't write O2 directly. So O is added, the symbol of oxidizing agent, and this is done with the help of acidified KMnO4, that is potassium manganate. This produces ethanoic acid, which has the general formula as CH3COOH. The structure of this will be learnt in detail in the video of carboxylic acids, but just in general we can understand that if ethanol is used, ethanoic acid will be produced. If we use propanol, propanoic acid will be produced, and so on. And along with this, we will get carbon dioxide as a byproduct. We will get water as a byproduct. And now if we balance the whole equation, the number of carbon and hydrogen are same. Only we need to balance is the oxygen, and there are 3 oxygen atoms present on the product side, so we need to add 2 with the oxygen. This makes a balanced reaction of oxidation of ethanol to ethanoic acid in the presence of acidified potassium manganate, but the same reaction can occur with the oxidation in air also. So this is one of the important reaction of alcohols. Other than that, alcohols are also used for the formation of esters. Now esters are very important chemicals, have a wide use, but to know the formation of esters, we need to know the structure of carboxylic acids also, because alcohols reacts with the carboxylic acids to form ester. So in the video of carboxylic acid, we'll be learning the formation of esters. So for now, we are just learning these 2 important reactions of alcohols. That is, first one is combustion, and the second one is oxidation of alcohols to carboxylic acids.